In this video, I'm gonna show you how to create a fun and eye-catching YouTube video intro using Adobe Express, the quick and easy Create Anything app. Creating videos can feel really overwhelming, especially for small business owners who are kind of juggling multiple responsibilities. Like, doing videos is just kind of mind-boggling. Especially when it comes to like adding intros and graphics to those videos, it might seem like a real extra challenge, but it really doesn't have to be complicated. In the search bar in Adobe Express, we can type YouTube intro in to find templates specifically designed for YouTube video openings. We can see that these are videos by the little play icon in the corner. So you want to choose a template that matches the vibe of your channel. For today's example, I'm going to be making a YouTube intro using a template for a fictional YouTube channel called Flavor Feast. We're gonna be featuring their recipe for cheeseburger nachos, which quite honestly sound phenomenal right now because I'm starving. So here we have our template in here. This is actually coming in at 1080 by 1920. We can change that if our video is 4K. Down here on the bottom, we can see the timeline for our intro. So if we hit play, it shows us what that looks like. We're gonna replace the video clip by coming up here to replace. And so if you have footage, we can upload it here from your device. If you're creating your own YouTube video, you're going to have footage of the thing that you're making, or maybe some B-roll of what you do, and that's where you're gonna wanna put this. So we've got our clip replaced. Now we're gonna adjust our text here. Cheeseburger nachos. Because this intro is for the nachos, but not our like standard channel, we're actually gonna change Sophia's style guide to Flavor Feast, which is the name of our channel. So we're just gonna double click on that text. Oh, I'm Canadian. What's the American spelling of flavor? F-L-A-V-O-R. So if there's something on here that we don't like, we can just select it, hit delete. So I'm thinking like red, punchy, poppy. So let's change the fill color to white, and let's change the shape to like red or something. With the template, it's already animated. We can change the animation down here on the left by clicking on animation and just kind of adjusting any of the elements here. So we can adjust the text the same way we would with like a static design by coming over here to the left, selecting text, changing fonts, changing colors, and then we can hit play below to preview what that looks like with the animation that's come in with that template. Because the clip that we've chosen is black at the beginning and then the cheese comes up, we might want to adjust that a little bit. We're just going to drag and crop our timeline so that cheese starts coming in right away. If we wanna see Flavor Feast coming in a little bit later, we can click on the text, come down here to our little timeline, and as we hover over the two lines on the edge, you can see our arrow changes, and we can just click and drag that. So here's the key when it comes to creating YouTube intros like this. Keeping it super short and sweet is super important. I'd actually prefer to see this 5 seconds. We're going to click and drag the edge. If we want to add some clips on the end here, we can add a scene. Add our video clips by uploading from device. If we're picking a stock video clip, so they don't have any footage of these delicious nachos. So we have two scenes here. We have our intro and then the following shot. We can actually add a transition here by clicking the plus button, hitting add transition. And as we hover over, we can see the different options that we have. We're gonna hit push. So now that we have our YouTube intro kind of how we like it, we've got our introduction with our text and our logo in it, and then we are following that up with a transition and a beauty shot of the finished product of our nachos. If we wanna add some music to this, up here we can select from sound effects, some stock music here. You wanna make sure that whatever audio you're using, whatever music you're using, you have permission to use. I'm just gonna click on it. It automatically puts it down in our timeline. You can see it right here. And then we can change it, whether if it fades in or out, change the volume. You really want to make sure when you're putting music in your videos, especially your intros, if there is dialogue, that you can hear the dialogue, that your music is not too loud. If you're like, that sounds good, make it a little bit quieter because it's still probably too loud. If we wanna change the song, we can come back here. And if you wanna find something like a little bit better, you can see that I've accidentally added two audio tracks. So there's two green lines here. So if we wanna get rid of one of those, we're gonna get rid of that blues track. We're gonna click delete, and now we just have the one. We can preview our design by coming down here. We can drag this playhead over to kind of scrub over our video here. And we can continue to add scenes if we wanna finish up our video in Adobe Express, we can do that. But I'm gonna export this to use. So we're gonna go to download. This is a video, so we're going to hit MP4. And then we have the original size, which is 1080p. My videos are typically 4K, so I'm gonna select 4K. Right here we have a warning that says, uploading to YouTube, find the content ID for your audio track in the audio properties panel. So you're gonna wanna include that in your description box just so you don't get flagged. Here's a pro tip. keep your dialogue running under the opening visuals to kind of maintain the flow of the video. This way you kind of avoid that kind of awkward pause between your intro and then getting into the video, and it kind of maintains the pacing of the edit. So here's an example of what that would look like. This is a cooking channel now, okay, ready? In this video, we're making some tasty cheeseburger nachos that literally take 10 minutes and they are so good. Cheeseburger nachos.
Cheeseburger nachos.
Cheeseburger.
Cheeseburger nachos. I'm absolutely starving, so that sounds delicious. Maybe after we've introduced that cheeseburger nacho recipe, we're gonna show some beauty shots as a little bit of a teaser on what's to come later to get people to stick around, because you wanna make sure that they're making the nachos. That is it. You've created a unique intro for your YouTube channel in minutes with like no animation experience needed. It is so easy, it's customizable. Try it out in your next video and let us know how it goes in the comments below.